You got an air flip kick, bro.
Only one side of three stocks, so it's not too bad. Donkey Kong. Wait, is this Nasir's first set on stream?
Yeah.
I forgot who's even here. Right. Man, shout out to Kobe. Taking game one off of Yeti. Yeah. Yeah, this dude has to be a Wi-Fi warrior because I've never heard of him in Smash 4. But at that Smash conference, he was kind of taking mad sets.
Did he beat a Smash conference?
He beat Matty G to get out of Pool's winner's side. And then when he got knocked in the losers, he beat like mad people. Stu, you can get on now. Oh, okay.
Sure. Where's Mini Boss? Does he want to hop on too? Okay. Stop the battle.
Donkey Kong. So this is the winner semifinal match between Blazing Pasta and Yoda Cage. Now we've seen Yoda Cage do pretty well for himself thus far in this tournament as we are approaching game number one, but
yeah. Pasta though, he's been like a brick wall in Ultimate so far.
Yeah, and it's been one which the entire Philadelphia scene has been slamming themselves against. Blazing Pasta off to a great start. Continue stage control.
This is going to be a very slow-paced set.
Oh, my. Blazing Pasta. Are you kidding me? Oh, Yoda Cage catches it, however. To no avail and back to neutral. But that's 120% points.
Well,
worth of damage.
He's right off the jump. That almost hit him. I feel like Yoda's been off stage for like most of this game.
Approximately 90% of it.
But surprisingly, it's pretty close.
Oh, you were saying something.
I was gonna say it's pretty close to even, but you got that fair. That was a good fair from Pasta.
Absolutely slaps him with the crown, and that's going to take stock number one.
Good backer, beating out the Peach Bomber.
Yeah, no, that backer, such a good tool.
Oh no. Oh my god. What happened to the stock?
What do you mean, what happened to it? It's. Oh, look at the side beats. Pot dodged. Yeah, and that's Yoda Cage, perhaps storming his way upon the comeback trail.
The stock is looking pretty unhealthy.
Yeah, no, it's not a whole lot.
I saw the F smash come out.
However, not a whole lot.
Yoda,
there you go.
Yoda's making it back. Good weight with the float, avoiding that. Oh my god.
Oh my gosh, but he teed himself up for the headbutt, Yoda Cage.
98.8 after the hit.
Yeah. Oh my. Gets tagged by the last hit down air. Gonna have to make it back onto the stage somehow. He won't do it that way. Oh.
Good air dodge.
Good air dodge. To avoid the turnip, and we have seen Blazing Pasta do that just one too many times.
Oh my
especially
god.
Especially for Yoda Cage's liking.
Donkey
the back
Kong.
Airs. Oh my goodness, Donkey Kong.
Is he dead? Counter.
With Blazing Pasta. And yeah, that'll do it. Blazing Pasta makes it back.
That was an untaggable too.
I believe so, yeah.
You can tell by the red splash on the stage spike.
Coming through with the info.
Good parry.
Parried.
The biggest ball paired I've seen today.
Yeah. And it's amazing how much of a point of importance parrying has become. Because I believe, what, you get an extra 3 frames of advantage off of a parry?
Yeah. Just about. If you're not counting the shield drop animation, then yes, 3 frames.
Believe. I could be wrong about that, and I certainly encourage people to call me out on that if
well,
I am wrong.
For example, a good way to put it is a good way to put it is like an up B out of shield will have a three.
Oh my gosh!
That was a DI mix-up, I think.
Yeah. Well, a good way to put that is game number one to Yoda Cage, challenging Blazing Pasta, perhaps, for the title of King of the Jungle here at the laboratory.
Yeah. Anyway, for parrying, what are you talking about?
Yeah, no, I cut you off. The game cut us off.
If you're doing, like, a up-y at a shield, you would have a three-frame advantage. If you're doing a smash attack at a shield, you have a 14-frame advantage besides up smash. Up smash, you get 3-frame advantage. And then any aerial, you get like.
So no matter what, you're still just trying to pick your safest option.
Not necessarily.
Oh.
Like if someone throws something not safe on me and I parry it, I'm going to try to go for the hardest option I can. Hardest punish I can.
At least if you're Yeah, if you're Blazing Pasta, who was the parrier in that
anyway,
case. Oh my!
This is looking a lot like game one.
Yeah, with Blazing Pasta all of a sudden jumping out to such an advantage. Hits him again with the turn up and the toad coming out.
Right,
Blazing
so I
Pasta
feel like
blazing through the first stock.
So now I feel like Pasta realized I wasn't edge guarding him hard enough. This character has a free recovery to hit. That would have killed him.
Series of down airs. Man, he is so good at mixing up his movement in the air.
Keeping him off stage.
Forward throw, tags him with the turnip once again, and he's unable to recover, and that is a stock that Yoda Cage, you know he wants back.
Oh my god.
Oh my goodness.
This man's a nut.
Oh, Blazing Pasta. However, he gets caught by that back air, and again, utilizing one of the most effective tools in DK set.
31
oh
damage.
My. Yeah, 31 damage for free, basically.
He earned it.
Oh, no, for sure.
Good jump away.
Oh, no.
Man, that sucks.
That is not the way that... I mean, there's opening the door, and then there's that. That is rough from Yoda Cage. And Blazing Pasta, I mean... That's the look on his face. We take those, man.
Oh, we will take those.
Always, especially against Yoda Cage, one of a very, let's be real, he is a smart dude, but he doesn't necessarily try to outthink himself by playing while playing Donkey Kong, which you can't afford to do, quite frankly. It's a very simple game plan that DK has, and it's a very effective one at that.
Yeah. I just hope he doesn't get tilted.
No, and certainly I do as well, just because, I mean, we have seen some quality gameplay.
Battlefield.
To game number one. Game number three as we go to Battlefield.
For sure this is Yoda's favorite stage.
Yeah. It's funny how we've seen him obviously prefers platforms in general. I mean, I remember him saying... I remember him going to Lilac Cruise a lot, in particular, in Smash 4, as Bowser Jr.
Good wave.
He's an agent of chaos, Yoda Cage. What can you say? Oh, caught by the side B. The Smash trying to golf him off the stage, and back air will do instead. And there it is. Let's go golfing, says Blazing Pasta as he takes stock number one. And again, these down airs.
He's doing so much damage.
Unrelenting in the air, Yoda Cage. I mean, what is there to do about that?
Not get hit.
I mean, right you are. I mean, he's not wrong. That's the thing. Like, I can't say he's wrong.
I mean, Peach is one of the last characters in the game I want to get hit by.
Oh,
might be dead.
Yeah.
Yep.
Shucks him off the stage, and Yoda Cage will take stock number one off of Blazing Pasta.
Right.
Very doable if game one is any indication. Probably just wants those platforms there so he can continue those up throw combos at that early percentage.
Yeah, might be able to try to squeeze an earlier stock because the transition from core to ultimate, Battlefield's blast zones are smaller.
Oh, gets tagged and makes his way back to the neutral state. Back air. Getting him off
good
the
wave.
Stage. Trying to assert stage control here and don't really want to be challenging Blazing Pasta in the air unless you have a concrete game plan.
Good forward air, re-getting stage. He's dead.
There you go. The throw off the top and just like that, down to his last stock is Blazing Pasta. He's made the most of, he's been making the most of these second stocks since Yoda Cage, aside from, of course, the last game, which was an unfortunate.
Yoda is living so much longer than Pasta is. And even though Pasta is more often than not mixing him for most of a stock, Yoda's making its way back.
And I mean, that's kind of the nature of the beast, literally with Donkey Kong. You're just going to, you're going to outlive most of what you do, but when a character hits as hard as Peach, and especially a character, a person that likes to go off the stage and challenge as often as Blazing
Good
Pasta
does.
Good
mix-up on recovery.
Bit of a shock that he's living so long, Yoda Cage, in that regard.
Might be dead.
Oh, the throw off the side, and that's not going to do it quite yet. Splendid DI. Oh my gosh, the Peach Bomber turns the match on its head, perhaps the set, and he steals game number three from Yoda Cage.
Did Yoda, I think that was a re-grab on the ledge because Yoda snapped the ledge, chased him to go for back airs, and re-snapped.
It sure seems like it, and I mean, Yoda Cage, you got to think if he's, got to wonder if he's playing that back in his head.
That situation was all or nothing because if the back airs, I feel like if he dropped Legend Backyard in time, it might have just completely snuffed out the Peach Bomber, but.
But no, he re-grabbed, didn't have any,
invincibility.
Had no more invincibility.
He got stage spiked.
He got caught. He got caught. What else is there to say? And that's unfortunate for Yoda Cage, but he's going to have to find a way against what is who's quickly becoming one of Tri-State's premier names. I mean, he's definitely already there, but he's challenging for the throne.
Yeah.
All in all, I mean, he's challenging 6WX on a regular basis. He's up there challenging all the big names after taking 17th place
at Glitch.
At Glitch 6.
Yeah, that was a really good showing from the Philly boys.
Yeah, he and Juice both taking 17th.
Interesting counterpick, Yoshi's Island Brawl. Oh my god.
Yeah, that is interesting. What does this do for Yoda Cage?
I don't know. I've no the damnedest of no clues.
Well, fair enough.
Badger. Oh, Nair, huh? I feel like this makes it easier for Donkey Kong to hit my turnips off stage. Safe on shield. Oh no.
Shoot, can't go. Oh, he has the bomb. Does not take advantage
Bruh.
Of it, however.
Dead.
There you go.
I don't want to say that Yoda Cage counter pick himself. The stages, but this stage is not helping him out at all.
I mean, he's been getting clunked by turnips pretty much the entire set. You would think that he'd do everything that he possibly could to make that more difficult, but then again, he also pineappled himself twice in game number two, so
yeah.
He wants to avoid that as well. You can see that being a commonality.
Oh, just the slants.
Oh,
the slants killed him.
Oh, my. Unfortunate.
You kind of picked himself.
Yeah.
Sorry, Ryan, but why'd you do this to yourself?
I mean, there's, you got to live and learn.
Yeah.
It's the unfortunate part of the game. I'm certainly no stranger to that. I know you aren't either.
Yeah.
And, counters him with the neutral B.
The shield pressure.
Beautiful from Blazing Pasta. I mean, when he gets stage control, he does not see it. That's the most impressive part.
Peach is so impressive on your shield.
Oh my gosh, yes. Oh, spiked. Yoda Cage.
He's desperate for this kill.
Well, he ate all of the up B in order to get that first stock.
But at what cost? Look at him. He's on.
Oh my gosh.
He's bleeding.
Yeah, seriously. Someone stop the damn match.
Side B.
Oh, and there you go.
I knew it.
Wow.
I knew it.
You you had like a Shulk vision, and you just called the side B.
I knew Yoda's desperate to get off ledge because he's been getting edge guarded to crap the entire set.
Yeah. Buffering. Yeah, welcome to Ultimate, my friend.